after budget Mahabharat. मोदी 3.0 बजट ट्रिगर्स वॉर.
आप अगर व्यवस्था बना के रखना चाहते हैं, सदन चलाना चाहते हैं, तो सदन इस व्यवस्था से चलेगा.
इंडिया ब्लॉक ओपन्स ऑफेंसिव.
ऐसा बजट मैं कभी नहीं देखा और ये सिर्फ किसी को खुश करने के लिए, खुर्ची बचाने के लिए वो ये सब हुआ है.
फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर निर्मला ब्रीथ्स फायर.
That in every budget, you don't get an opportunity to name every state of this country. If the speech does not mention the name of a particular state, does it mean that the schemes of the government of India don't go to these states? They go as per a routine.
Budget showdown. That is our top focus on 6 p.m. Prime.
Hello and welcome. Good evening. You're watching 6 p.m. Prime here on India Today. I'm Akshita Nandagopal. And over the next half hour, we'll be recapping for you all that played out in Parliament. A day after the budget was presented, a united opposition has alleged that there's discrimination, that the Modi government is giving funds, money, only for their own allies, referring to Andhra and Bihar. Several opposition rule states are choosing to boycott the Niti Aayog meet. We'll be getting you some of the reactions, highlights from the Parliament session and much more. The budget that was presented in Parliament yesterday by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has triggered a fresh political war of words. The India bloc leader started off the day by staging this mega protest outside Parliament and carried it forward inside too, with sloganeering ruckus being reported in both houses. Essentially, the opposition's grouse is this. They're saying that the government has gone ahead and given allocations only to states they favor, only to their allies, and said that there's discrimination against opposition-ruled states. Let's get you this report to get you details of what really played on in Parliament and the government's counter.
The opposition is up in arms against Budget 2024. India bloc MPs staged a protest outside Parliament claiming that the opposition states had been ignored.
Budget kam, chapat jyada lag raha hai. Budget ke saath chapat laga di gayi hai. Aur khaskar Uttar Pradesh ke log niraash hain. Kyunki jis tarike se Uttar Pradesh dekh raha tha ki Uttar Pradesh ko sabse jyada labh milega, bhedbhav nahi hoga. Kyunki double engine ki sarkar hai wahan. दिल्ली में भी उनकी है, यूपी में भी वही है, लेकिन इधर कुछ देखने को नहीं मिल रहा है.
The budget, the government of India is not considered our request. It was made during pre-budget discussion.
प्रधानमंत्री सरकार बचाओ योजना कल घोषित की है, यूनियन बजट नहीं था वो. वैसे ही प्रधानमंत्री महाराष्ट्र विरोधी योजना कल बजट में दिखाई दी. जब महाराष्ट्र 10 साल से जब से भारतीय जनता पार्टी आई है, महाराष्ट्र को कुछ नहीं मिला है.
Inside Parliament too, political fireworks exploded. There was massive sloganeering in both the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, with the Congress leading the charge against the Modi government. But Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman hit back.
Na Tamil Nadu ko mila, na Kerala ko mila, na Karnataka ko mila, na Maharashtra ko mila, kisi state ko kuch nahi, Delhi ko nahi diya. तो मैं कितने दिन ओडिशा को कुछ नहीं दिया, तो ऐसा बजट मैं कभी नहीं देखा.
कांग्रेस पार्टी हैज बीन इन पावर फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम इन दिस कंट्री. दे प्रेजेंटेड सो मेनी डिफरेंट बजट्स एंड दे वुड नो क्लियरली दैट इन एवरी बजट यू डोंट गेट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू नेम एवरी स्टेट ऑफ दिस कंट्री. आई वुड चैलेंज द कांग्रेस पार्टी फॉर ऑल द बजट स्पीचेस दैट दे हैव डिलीवर्ड. That in each of the budget speeches, have they named every state of this country? This is an outrageous allegation.
Coalition means cooperation. Coalition means collaboration. Coalition means cohesion. But after yesterday, one thing is very clear, sir. That coalition means appeasement and compensation.
Even yesterday, the TMC questioned the budget, saying, oh, nothing has been given to Bengal. Let me just highlight the fact that the several schemes given by Honorable Prime Minister in the last 10 years have not even been implemented in West Bengal. Health insurance. And you have the audacity to ask me now? Bengal should correct its course.
The opposition alleges that the Modi 3.0 budget is a budget to save the Prime Minister's chair, or Kursi Bachao budget. The showdown has set the tone for the monsoon session of Parliament. With Piyush Mishra and Rahul Gautam in Delhi, Bureau Report, India Today.
And joining us here on India Today is Uddhav Sena, Member of Parliament in the Rajya Sabha, Priyanka Chaturvedi. Thank you very much for joining us here on India Today. I'm sure you've heard, Priyanka Chaturvedi, what Nirmala Sitharaman said in Parliament today. She's essentially put forward this counter to the opposition's charge that the opposition ruled states haven't gotten anything, saying just because I haven't named a state in my speech doesn't mean they haven't received anything. She's asking if you're expecting her to go ahead and name all 28 states in her speech.
No, if she's not naming all the 28 states, she should not have named the other two states also. This is what discrimination is about, no? When you're choosing to pick two states and keep repeating those two states and what you're doing for those two states in your speech, while ignoring the rest, what we are saying is don't name any state. You're the union minister. You're a minister for India. India includes all these states, not just Bihar and Andhra Pradesh. So this is our point of view also. Don't name any state. Speak for the Indian Union, which you haven't done. You've shown discrimination there. And that is why we have an objection. We object to the way the two names were picked up to highlight, while the rest were ignored. And now coming to every state-wise allocation.
Yep.
She was saying that she's made some allocation. So when she's saying she's making allocation, now you must say, she kept saying, there is an allotment for Maharashtra. Maharashtra, there is nothing. And I repeat, there is nothing. And I repeat, there is nothing. Maharashtra, for every rupee that it sends to the center, what it gets back is 3 paise to 5 paise. We don't grudge that. We don't grudge that. If it is used to ensure that there's development for all states equally. But we will definitely grudge it if you are using the funds that come from Maharashtra to politically help you save your government. And that is a problem. While you're ignoring the state of Maharashtra, you're using it as a cash cow and handing over money like it's your own money.
Referring to Maharashtra, she's spoken of the 76,000 crore port project in Vadhavan, saying we just granted that to Maharashtra. So how can you claim Maharashtra has been ignored?
So let me also clear this to you. Ask the people of Maharashtra, especially where this port is coming up, Panvel, whether they were seeking this project. That's point one. Then I would request you to do a basic Google timeline search, ma'am, and check when was this project approved. In 2020. In 2024, saying that, oh, we are giving you 76,000 crores, you're not doing Maharashtra any favor. And I would again repeat, check with the people of Maharashtra, especially the area where this project is coming up, and ask those residents what they feel about this project. And then we shall speak.
Okay, the other aspect of this, Priyanka Chaturvedi, and I don't want to go into, you know, whether which project is favored, not favored, but if you look at what the BJP has said, they've claimed that, look, this is something that the Congress did as well, that they'd favor their allies. That very often in their budgets too, they would go ahead and pick states and give fund allocated. So why is the opposition crying foul now?
I'll tell you why. 2014, what was BJP's narrative? BJP's narrative was that Congress government needs to go, the UPA government needs to go because of various other reasons, and that we will bring a different style of governance and different format of governance. Why are they harping back on what about you? Oh, look, you did it then. You promised a different chapter for India. Just because you are failing to deliver a new chapter to India, the new development targets for India, to ensure that India progresses equally, and because you have been beaten at the hustings and you haven't got a single party majority, you have to please your allies in the hope that they will allow you to run the government for 5 years. I have a simple question to make. This amount, 15,000 allocation that they have said, is as per the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Bill, the commitment was for a special status. Why is Andhra Pradesh being denied that? In Odisha, the Bharatiya Janata Party's manifesto said that they will give a special status category to Odisha. Why have they ditched the people of Odisha? Now, in Bihar, this is, forget the special status package, etc. Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his campaign, 8 years ago, 8 or 10 years ago, I don't recall when, he said, main 1,20,000 crore budget ka package dunga. What happened to that? So, all we are trying to say is that just because it suits you politically now, you're making these announcements, but what truly matters is that you said you would change how earlier governments used to work and you will bring in a new kind of politics, development politics. What you're doing is not development. What you're doing is mere politics to seek your seat and to be in power.
Okay, so that's your charge of the BJP. I want to keep politics aside for a moment. And let's look at it this way, Priyanka Chaturvedi, that should we really be discussing which state gets how much? Schemes that are put out in the budget goes to every state.
Yes.
You know, there are
yes,
allocations
ma'am.
Given to Andhra and Bihar, which perhaps the states need. They're in dire need of this kind of an allocation for development.
Ma'am, I believe we are a union of states and every single state should be considered equal. That's point one. Just because Andhra Pradesh's governments did not fail up to, I mean, at one point in time, Andhra Pradesh was developing at a faster rate than Maharashtra, was creating jobs faster than Maharashtra.
No, but
and
today
this is
it
not
isn't.
About
and if we start talk about how
all,
much state gives versus how much state gets, is that a
you
dangerous
me
narrative
to, speak,
to get into?
Please allow me to speak.
Sure,
allow,
go ahead.
No, you cannot interrupt me. You've called me on your show, allow me to speak. If you have a problem with that, you can rebut me, right? You asked me, should we be doing this, keeping politics aside? So yes, that's exactly what I'm telling you. Keep the politics aside. Don't you think Maharashtra, which is the nerve center, the financial, which houses the financial capital of India, deserves attention? Or you think it is an unnecessary ask of Maharashtra? A gift city that goes to Gujarat, a gift city can very well come to Maharashtra. Maharashtra can do well to have more ports and more connectivity. Maharashtra can do exceedingly well if we have well-functioning railways and networks. Please allow me to complete, ma'am. I come from Maharashtra. I represent Maharashtra. And since you asked, I'm not talking about my politics. I'm talking about how development is being denied to some states over the expense of some pleasing that they have to do to maintain their position for the next 5 years. I'm not grudging that Andhra Pradesh has got these funds. I'm not grudging that Bihar is getting these funds. But my grudge is that do not use this politically. What were they doing before these alliance partners came on their side? Till the time TDP was not with them, did they give anything to Andhra Pradesh? Did they give anything to Bihar till JDU didn't come to their side? So let's not get into this. I mean, it's very, very obvious that they have chosen politics over development.
Okay.
And that is what we are highlighting.
Okay. Now let me just ask you a quick follow-up. As far as Maharashtra goes, are you saying that Maharashtra has gotten zero? No fund allocation, but are you saying overall Maharashtra has got zero, no development projects?
Can you tell me confidently, in the budget speech or in the budget, any specific allocation made for the state of Maharashtra?
No,
if
there was no fund allocation,
that,
I agree. No fund allocation, which is why I'm asking you. Are you
so
saying
then
no
what,
development
what are we
projects
about?
Also?
Then why are you
saying
going
no development
on, why
projects
I,
also?
No, so again, I'm let me repeat to you. Let me again repeat to you and ask you that is there any specific development allocation for the state of Maharashtra?
Priyanka Chaturvedi. No, so I'm talking about fund allocation.
I've
discussed this. I've said, yes, there's
not.
No fund allocation. There's no fund allocation for Maharashtra. Yes, that's given. But you also say, you know, what about railways? What about ports? Are you saying there's no development projects coming to Maharashtra?
Are you trying to now argue? One second, ma'am. My last 10 years. Okay, let's go to 10 years. 2014 to 2024. Development projects for Maharashtra have almost been dependent on how Bharatiya Janata Party, on which side of the divide they are in. Let me give you an example. The Metro 3 project, where we propose that Kanjurmarg salt pan land should be handed over to the state government of Maharashtra so that a car shed, instead of destroying the forests of RA colony, RA forest, can be coming up at the salt pan lands. It was a very central government that went to the court and stalled that. And do you know what's happening to that Kanjurmarg salt pan lands right now? It is being handed over to Adani. Under the garb of what? under the garb of Dharavi redevelopment. You're talking about urban housing, sir. Yesterday somebody was arguing that urban housing would come in Mumbai too. You are making the people of Dharavi homeless to support a project of your capitalist friend, Mr. Adani. Under the garb of Dharavi redevelopment project, over 1,000 acres are being handed over of central government land as well as a state government land to Mr. Adani. Okay. Will you all go check at what per 1,000 square feet he is selling this land for? Every TDR that he sells to another builder, he is getting a 40% higher margin. This is what they're doing to Maharashtra and Mumbai. So I can talk to you about everything. But most of the development that has happened in Maharashtra is because of a fiscal prudence policy that Maharashtra was following and being the leader in as far as and understanding its responsibility towards development. Unfortunately, the central government
has chosen
development is based on politics
of every state. Thank you, Priyanka Chaturvedi, for joining us here on India Today. You've heard from Priyanka Chaturvedi there, representing the opposition. You've heard what they have to say, and they're grouse right now against the central government. We'll leave it to you to decide whether you think the budget allocations to Andhra and Bihar in particular were fair or not. Former Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister, YSRCP Chief Jagan Mohan Reddy led a massive protest in the national capital today over political violence in his state in Andhra Pradesh. But what grabbed eyeballs was the support that he received from political parties, all of them belonging to the India bloc. Now, remember that Jagan previously hasn't committed his support to either the NDA or the India bloc, but has often voted in favour of NDA in Parliament. Is the tide shifting now in favour of the India bloc? Will Jagan perhaps lean towards the alliance in Parliament? Let's get you details in our next report.
Jagan Mohan Reddy has brought his fight against TDP to Delhi. The former Andhra Chief Minister staged a symbolic protest in the national capital against the Naidu government, citing the spike in political violence in the state. Jagan lashed out at TDP, demanding intervention by the central government while leading a five-hour agitation at Jantar Mantar.
More than 1,000 cases of assault, vandalism taking place. More than 2,700 families were forced to leave their villages. And even now, cops, rather than giving protection to the villagers of the opposite party, are asking those villagers to go out of the village.
But what grabbed eyeballs was the political messaging involved. Joining Jagan during his protest were a slew of India bloc leaders. The first to meet Jagan was Akhilesh Yadav, who joined the stir and expressed his solidarity with Jagan's fight.
जो तस्वीरें और जो वीडियो देखने को मिल रहा है कि जब से सरकार में आए हैं कि उन्होंने दूसरे लोग जो पॉलिटिकल लोग हैं उनके साथ अन्याय करना शुरू किया है जो जनप्रतिनिधि रहे हैं जो इलेक्टेड मेंबर्स रहे हैं उन पे भी जानलेवा हमला करना ये कहीं भी स्वस्थ लोकतंत्र में और स्वस्थ लोकतंत्र का परिचय नहीं हो सकता है.
And then a slew of other opposition leaders followed. Sanjay Raut, Priyanka Chaturvedi, Arvind Sawant met Jagan too.
In 46 days after the changing the government, 40-45 dinon mein is prakar ka political revenge liya jata hai aur is prakar se liya jata hai. Karyakartaon ke haath pair tode jate hain. Karyakartaon ki khoon ki nadiyan bahai jati hai. Ye main pehli baar dekh raha hoon.
Several other leaders too met Jagan, from ASP to TMC to JMM to AIADMK. These shows of solidarity of India bloc leaders with Jagan has sparked a speculation on Jagan's political loyalties in Delhi. Is Jagan considering joining the India bloc? Well, so far he's made no such move, and in Parliament too has refused to back the opposition's agenda on a slew of issues. But with opposition leaders now standing by him, could Jagan be considering backing India bloc along the same lines as he did with the BJP previously? Bureau Report, India Today.
And let's get you an exclusive conversation with Jagan Mohan Reddy, where we asked him particularly about which side he backs, the NDA or the India bloc. Here's what he said.
You've invited India Alliance partners here, you know, India Alliance MPs rather, not partners so far. But you have been supporting the BJP in the past on the floor of the House on several issues, including Delhi Services Bill. Number one, Do you regret being with BJP, supporting the BJP in the past? Number two, what are you seeking from the Home Ministry while you are in the national capital?
See, this is not the question of who is who. This is a question of attack on democracy. We have given these invites to everybody, to Congress, to BJP, to every regional party as well. And I am thankful for all the regional heads that they have sent their representatives, that they have voiced, they have seen what has happened, and they have voiced their concern. That should be the spirit of democracy. In a democracy, this kind of madness should not be supported just because somebody is an alliance partner or just because somebody is part of them. Yes, we had asked for appointments as well. We've asked the Honorable Prime Minister for his appointment as well. We've asked the Honorable Home Minister also for his appointment. We've also asked for an appointment from the Honorable President of this country as well. And yes, given time, given the opportunity, we would definitely represent to them as well in person, also showcasing the plight of Andhra Pradesh. See, the fact is we have invited them. He had all the room. He had all the opportunity to come here and to see for himself what has happened here. And he had all the opportunity to make a comment on this, condemning what has happened. He had all the opportunity, but yet, for some strange reason, because he's already in close tie-up with Chandrababu Naidu, unfortunately. And Chandrababu Naidu is playing both games, both sides. That is the reason why these people chose to blindly support him, even though he's not, ghastly incidents took place, which is not right.
How do you see this VCK's invite to India block then, if you're saying that Congress...
I condemn both BJP, I condemn both Congress as well. Both of them should have come. They should have sent their representatives and they should have condemned this act. This is not something which is to be...